How many of you are having your own website? How many of you are very active on social networking sites? You don't have to go to the market to communicate. The market is on your mobile. So that how to segregate the population in different target groups. Now, these target groups are active. Some groups are active more in one kind of network. Some other groups are more active in another kind of network. So you, as an entrepreneur, got to figure out what kind of network you should use to promote your business. That's required some kind of thinking, strategizing. No longer that people will find your product. You have to find people whom to sell. Why should I look at your product, your information, unless you actually attract me? We have to offer everything to the customer on his or her fingertips. And for that, and that to happen, you have to figure out how to develop your social media strategy, how to reach them in time. Because most of the entrepreneurs I know, they are thinking they are doing great things. They're developing a great game. They are developing a great product. To me, that is the basic minimum. Suppose you today understood, this is the target group which is using Facebook, you want to concentrate on that. Immediately, you also have to figure out tomorrow what is going to happen to Facebook with this target group. Otherwise, you'll be spending so much of effort, money, to actually attract that audience, and suddenly that audience is already has migrated to somewhere else. Now, 50% of world population today is less than 30 years. 50%, okay. And 7 million of them in the US left Facebook in last 3 years. 7 million of that young population. So suppose if you're, okay, for example, suppose you're in the gaming industry, you're writing a game. This is the target group. And if you're concentrating too much on Facebook, well, it doesn't require rocket science to understand what's going to happen to you. Today, 50% of your e-commerce traffic is happening on mobile. So that means nobody is going to actually search probably specially, go to a desktop, sit there and search for your product. What they want on the go, if they get something from you through their preferred network, they see something and you know, suppose if that person, suppose I am really interested in a bottle of honey and I get something here, something, you know, on the go, I quickly look at it and probably prefer to get in touch with you. You have your own business. Now, what you have to do, initially it is very important that you figure who are your most potential clientele right now, whom you think that your most important value probably in a customer. You create a profile. Let it initially start it on a very small scale. Audience profile in order of importance, it's very important. So you what would be your key message then to that customer? Some people also write blogs. Facebook popularity, but when you are planning your activity on Facebook, just don't take it for granted that if I do it very successfully on Facebook, I'll be achieving my goal. But somebody complains, how you handle that in a transparent way and also on the network and with that person, that goes along with that person may become your brand ambassador. Give some thought that how excited the reader would be while reading that, looking at that. Put yourself in those customers. There is, now a lot of monitoring tools are available. Suppose mention app. The moment you understand that the target audience is initially mentioning, and now you design that content in such a way that those people at least will not go away because there is an interest in it. Today, if I am buying a product and if I get some additional knowledge around that would be much more valued, than only merely that, the product. If you are having Facebook and all these things, so on your website, on your blog, you keep those buttons so that they can go to your, suppose they are reading your blog, they're able to go to your social networking site, Facebook. And by putting this button, you are creating a community of people around your brand. You have decided that, okay, you want to work with Facebook or Twitter, now commit some time on a daily basis. Because time is money. 24 hours is becoming more and more scarce. You don't have enough. Maybe 2 years back, you could spend 1 hour just like that. Today you can't. 2 years back, the amount of information probably you had to process per hour. Today you have to process much more because every second, every hour, enormous amount of information is getting added to the network. Don't rush to share. Kind of create an editorial board for you. Okay, this is what I'm getting. Then once you know, okay, this is a very valuable thing, share it now. This kind of action plan, I thought that you can prepare for yourself and stick to it. Call to action. I mean, what you want your reader, who is on your network, what you want that reader to do. In a knowledge economy, by sharing knowledge, you are not losing anything. Actually, together you are gaining. You create content, you publish, you then distribute to different networking, to different networks, and then you analyze that. See, once you distribute to your network, then you have to, after that, you have to figure out what's happening. How many people are going? You analyze and again, you know, optimize. This kind of seminar is important only when, after some time, we see that how it has brought some change in your business, you know? So keep sharing. I think by sharing, all of us grow.